So we'll look now at another Lord of the Flies essay that was an A star. Obviously, if you're not doing the book, this is still worth reading. Simply, you can see obviously how the student has shaped their writing and obviously why they're actually getting marks. So a very concise introduction. The opening of Golding's Lord of the Flies is not overtly as dark as the situation on the island becomes, but there are words and actions that quietly suggest what might and does happen. So I guess the question here must have been something with regards to how is language used in the book. From the very first paragraph, Golding establishes the dual nature of the island and what effect the boys have on it, straight into the themes. He describes the long scar, embedded quote, the effect of the plane crash on the jungle. Already here, paradise is marred, God chosen word, quite specifically by the boys' introduction to the island, and this foretells or foreshadows how they will further scar the island. Good use of metaphor in his own writing, for example, in the fires they start, and how imperfect the relationship is from the beginning. This is also emphasized by Golding's use of language, describing a bird call as a witch-like cry, the image of witch-like giving a darker side to the island again, and obviously could have actually, that's really well noted, but obviously could have linked it to the kind of the chanting and the war cries that we have later on with Jack's tribe. The witch-like cry is quickly echoed by another, and this is how Piggy's introduced to us. Even before being described as a fat boy plump and his windbreaker greasy, all adjectives that set him apart as weak and an outsider, the fact that Piggy echoes a witch-like cry specifically sets him apart again and hints at his fate, his eventual murder, obviously maybe like the treatment of witches, but that is brilliantly introduced. Just so many embedded quotes and just showing all different aspects of how the language is actually used. It specifically sets him apart again and hints at his fate, his eventual murder, like witches that were burnt often with little reason of evidence in past times. His death is senseless and a result of the return to savagery and tribalism by the boys throughout. So that's a good example there of touching on the themes. The opening of Lord of the Flies also defines clearly divisions of the strong and the weak, using Ralph and Piggy as a template for the larger divisions to come in the book. For the example, the harsh totalitarian leadership of Jack versus Ralph's more democratic approach, well worded and obviously picking up on two main themes there. Influenced by Piggy, where Jack's tribalism is victorious by using Biggin's strength to hunt and bully like a pack with Jack as their alpha male. Ah, excellent rendition there, obviously discussing that with them was obviously terms, excuse me, that we actually refer to animals with on Discovery shows and obviously in Nature Discourse. Example of this suggestion of division are where Piggy asks for Ralph's name and waits to be asked his name in turn, but this proffer of acquaintance was not made, showing from the four, it's quite classically written, that Piggy is lesser than Ralph in status. Also again, Piggy's described as following Ralph, the fat boy hung steadily at his shoulder. This class distinction on the island becomes important as Jack's atavistic primitivism leads to the death of Piggy and the torture of Sam and Eric. Okay, so obviously plotting, mentioning other points in the book and obviously what things lead to later on. Finally, one other event that is quite strongly suggested in the opening of the novel is the loss of society and the descent into savagery. Ralph says, perhaps there aren't any grown-ups anywhere, and then shortly after, in the delight of a realized ambition, stood on his head. This is interesting because later in the book, he becomes the champion of the lost democracy. We ought to comb our hair and find the conch, a symbol of the old civilization and rules. But as he stands on his head, Golding could be suggesting the reversal of delight of their freedom from society's structures, which occurs with Jack's violence and bloodlust for hunting. Brilliant use of the actual metaphoric, the symbolic idea there. Society is going to be turned on its head. Throughout the novel, Golding, using language more and more subtly, suggests the darkness in the island or the events to come. Live it like in the opening, for example, he describes the ocean at one point like a saturation of blood, or of an image of the bloodshed to come, which gives the reader a sense of foreboding. Also, Golding continues to use the character specifically to embody ideas. Ralph shows democracy, Jack fascism, Sam and Eric the obedient masses in society, and Simon a character who can be compared to Jesus. Again, the symbolism and the metaphors mentioned there are a possible comparison, and religion are possible ideas he embodies. And this last part here is very summarical. It's just kind of getting his, this is, he seems to just be not really concluding here, but just getting in what he knows, and obviously just showing the exam in that. But obviously throughout what we've seen already, the confidence has to be there to actually show that this is well worth an A star. This got 27 out of 27, and the reason obviously because it makes links to later on in the book. It analyzes the language in death, it shows a symbol and touches on the themes, touches on the writer's intentions, and it only has to do it once or twice each, as you see, and hopefully this will show you that an A star isn't beyond most of you, especially if you look over the notes that we have online. It touch upon all these things, which should keep them fresh in your mind.